Hello, my name is Cheryl Belkin Epstein, and I teach the history of ballet at Canada's National Ballet School. La Bayadère was created in 1877 by the French-born choreographer Marius Petipa when he was 59 years old and had been living in Russia for 30 years. It is based on the Romantic tradition in ballet and has many of the characteristics of that style. It is set in an exotic location, in this case India, and is driven by its narrative, a dramatic story of love and betrayal with not one love triangle, but two. And of course it has the requisite white act, an act populated by otherworldly female beings all dressed identically in white tutus. The ballet tells the story of Nakia, the Bayadère, or temple dancer of the title, who is in love with a handsome warrior named Solar, who has pledged his love to her over the sacred fire of the temple. But Solar is a flawed hero, and in spite of his pledge to Nakia, is overwhelmed by the great wealth and beauty of the Raja's daughter, Gamzati, and agrees to marry her, setting off a series of intrigues and acts of revenge, which ultimately result in the death of Nakia. Following the death of Nakia is the famous Kingdom of the Shades scene, a landmark in the history of ballet. In this scene, Solar, overcome with remorse over the death of Nakia, seeks solace in a dream in which he sees a vision of the shade, that is the ghost of Nakia, who emerges from a crevice in a mountain of the Himalayas and begins a short sequence of steps. Then her image multiplies repeatedly as one by one the female members of the corps de ballet emerge from the same spot and join in the ongoing repetition of this short sequence of steps, eventually making their way down the mountainside and organizing themselves in perfect parallel lines perpendicular to the front of the stage, looking not unlike the columns of the buildings of St. Petersburg, Petipa's adopted city. This long, slow repetition of the short choreographic phrase is calming, and the highly charged emotional story is left behind, as the subject of the dancing that follows becomes classical ballet itself and the beauty of its structure and form. How the dancers are arranged on the stage and the steps that they do within that arrangement reflect classical ideals of beauty and harmony in which everything is clear, balanced, and symmetrical. This scene, with its emphasis on pure academic ballet, is able to stand alone without any reference at all to the story in which it is placed, and it is for this reason that it is considered a landmark in the history of ballet, for it is understood as a precursor to the plotless ballets of the 20th century, in which ultimately setting and story would be completely abandoned in favor of formal abstract beauty. I hope you enjoy the ballet.